Hey, but what? Why did you give it to me?
You didn't even get your face in it. You
good.
Had your eyebrows.
1 more minute.
1 more minute.
All right, hey guys,
hey, what?
Let's go ahead and
circle up.
So we have this great person, keep grabbing that remote. We have this great person that's actually going to be speaking for us today. You know, he's very good at what he does. He's earned this position through hard work, grit, intensity, consistency, all the C words that you could think of. And that's why he's going to be running this meeting. So I advise you to grab your pen, grab your notebook, grab your face, grab a bag of confidence and student mentality, and come back up here because we're going to be listening to the one, the only, the great, Tracy J.
Yeah,
your mama loved me.
That's my downline.
Yeah. Your mama loved me.
Super senior.
All right. Super fast. Boom. It's all right. Your mama liked me. What's all good? Whatever.
My mom does. My mom loves me.
Sonia, we know that's you.
Why are you loving Gabby? Because
that's funny.
No, she does. Does she or does she not love me?
She didn't like you during Dream Song. But she loves me now.
She loves me now.
Cut the cameras.
You're teaching my son a lot. They like their father figures in
I like to set up a one-on-one with you.
Toothies.
My mom.
I love to set up a one-on-one with you. All right, does everybody have a notebook? Everybody got a pen? All that. All right. So, because we're going to have, we have a lot of transition now. Retail, they're going to start building their people. When it comes to AW, we got a new squad in. And now we're really, we trimmed down the fat. We went from almost 45 people, guys, down to like now 14 or 15 leaders from that. You know? And that's how it is. You got to trim the fat. You're going to, it's LOA. You get in a bunch of people, and you gotta find out who are the, which of these people are worth. Woo! You drop that. Woo! We ain't missing.
Yeah.
We ain't missing. You gonna find it.
You're too slick.
He was I seen the movie. He was Velcro's. But either way, so there's a lot of transition. Can someone tell her to shut up? There's a lot of. I'm losing my train of thought right now. Where was that? Yeah, there's a lot of change going on, which is why I really want to go over what is the standard for us. What is the standard for HK? What is the standard for our dream team? I had this name for my team since I was like a level one, trying to figure out what does my team need to do. And I call it a dream team. I'm Michael Jordan. I need my Scottie Pippen. I need my freaking, who else would I want? Kerr. I need my little Kerr. That's Jared. Jared is my little Kerr. He just does everything for me. Who else? Rodman. Dennis Rodman. Who's my bad boy? I'm looking for my bad boy. No. But what I want to kind of go over is that we set standards, not goals. Standards. The reason why I would always teach people that is because, what the heck? Because when you set a goal and when you hit it, you're done. Okay, there's nothing after that. Oh, I want to lose this amount of pounds. Cool. Then you're going to eat and you gain that back in 2 months. But when you have a standard for yourself, there's always room for improvement, which is why this is called the standard for a dream team. And what time is it? I don't want to go overboard.
That's 49, sir.
Okay, set an alarm for 11.
Someone set an alarm for hour 1.
Standard for dream, set an alarm for 11. Sonya trying to not lose to Veronica or Brandon. All right, so there's three areas for our company that we need to, you drop that, so. But there's three areas in our day-to-day that we need to find victory in. Okay, can anybody tell me those three?
Field goals.
Okay, not goals, but field.
Office.
Home.
Home. There are three places that's gonna add value to your success here, all right? So, ask yourself, what defines victory? What is victory for us? How do we win today? Because what so many people do is they dictate their day of growth into management based on how good they did in the field. And that's it. If they got zero that day, who cares about the three interviews they killed? Who cares about the mock interviews they killed? Who cares about the call they were on? They're just more focused on, oh, I got zero in the field. Does that signify victory? No. It's way bigger than that. Because at the end of the day, most salesmen aren't good leaders, aren't good managers in this business. We all been hiring, a lot of us been hiring. We all know those sales guys that we always hired, they didn't really last too long, right? It's because they're too much salesy. You know, they focus on that rather than building and developing people. All right, so there's three areas. There's the field. There's also the office. But then there's also home. And I'm gonna define what is victory in all three of these that will actually show you that you are way, way more victorious if you hit these rather than just focusing on the field. Because how many of us had a great Atmo, good morning, got some one-on-ones in, got some good fruit, then you go to the field and you crap the bed? How many of us have done that? And now the rest of your night, it's done for, right? You're like, oh, Tracy's gonna rip my tail. Yeah. I freaking didn't do anything. I got zero. Oh, I'm in it. You know, you lose your confidence that you had going to the field. You know, because you kind of just focused on the field. The field is the most important thing. However, this, what you do in the field benefits what?
Your pay.
It benefits your bank account. That's it. What you do in the field only benefits your bank account. You're able to make money while you're learning how to run my company. Sure. But office and home, guess what that benefits? Your future, your growth. Okay? And that's why I'm gonna show you what pertains as victory for us. So the first one, what is the standard for us in the field? It's 130 doors. Hitting your LOA. Top twos. When it comes to HI, 100 plus in HI. Talk to every freaking Costco member there is, even the guard dog. Okay? When it comes to AW, that's 85 plus talk twos. That's the standard. 130 doors, 100 talk twos in the store, 85 talk twos in the field. Okay? As well as a 2.5 average for HI. And a 7.0 average for AW. Want something you got to strive for. Does that make sense? No, that is a standard. That's not a goal. Once you hit it, you're not going to hit it again. No, that is a standard. I need to talk to 100 people in the store a day. If I know I did that, I crossed that off. Did I knock on 130 doors? Am I at 2.5 right now? If it's Tuesday or if it's Wednesday, I already have 2 days under my belt, am I at least at 5 appointments that are verified with HI? That means I'm above my numbers. If it's Wednesday, am I close to around 14? Am I 13 or 12? That's still almost close, but that is the standard. That's pushing me towards something. You know, it's not, hey, you need 8 sales, you need this or that. No, it's just like the standard, just the basics, the process, not the product. The standard, how to get to those type of numbers. You talk to as many people as possible. You knock on a bunch of doors, and you just have an average. Focus on that type of average for yourself. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Now, for the office, 15 to 20 minutes of solo game planning. Game planning, personal development. What are you doing to add value? Are you doing anything that's gonna really help you later on this week or later on this day? What are you doing to add value? Are you grabbing Sonia for 5 minutes after leaders meeting and say, hey, can you help me with paid services before you run this impact? You're practice pitching 10 minutes before everybody else because that extra 10 minutes is gonna compound. If you practice at 9:50, rather than at 10 a.m. like everybody else, and you build a team of 7-8 guys, and you're practice pitching at 9:50 right here while everybody else is doing other stuff, you have your squad just practice pitching, that 10 minutes every day, that's a whole hour a day. Now, to compound that for the next five months, like how much better is your team going to be at pitching and selling just based off of an extra 10 minutes? It's compound effect. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Next one. Greet people. Did you go up and greet everybody in here? Because once you're in management, you have to do that. I gotta say, hey, what's up? What's up, O'Dally? What's good, Sonia? Matthew, you know, you gotta do all that. No, you gotta greet people.
That was good.
But as a manager, you have to do that. I wanna see, do you have that standard to where you can do that already to show me you're ready for that position?
Yes, sir.
Next one. You gotta be in the group chat. I hate being a lefty. Group chat 4 times or more. If you're out there or if you're here with me and you're not adding value, you're not doing any chat encouragement, picking somebody up at least 4 times, you go a whole day without doing anything in the chat, how can you lead people? And I get it, sometimes you're at 0 and everybody else is doing well. Sometimes you gotta be the one and say, hey, you know what? Look, I'm not doing well right now, and I know I'm a leader, but I'm gonna change it around. And if anybody else wants to compete with me, let's do it. Who gets the next one on the board? So that's how you create chat encouragement. Not chat engagement, I want you to encourage people, chat encouragement. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Yeah.
Next one, 10 minutes of owner shadowing. What are you doing with me? Are you following me everywhere? Are you asking questions? Are you annoying me like Sam or Frashad 24/7 or Kyle sometimes? No, ownership, 10 minutes of that. Who's above you are you following? What conversations is Tracy having? What is Maria doing with inventory? What is Ernie doing right now? What is this leadership combo he's doing? What is Matt doing with Salesforce and trying to cut tea? That's 10 minutes of owner shadowing. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Next, another standard. Hire 2 people. Did you hire 2 people? If it's Thursday and you're having a bad day, and you're going through your stuff, did I greet people today? Yes. Did I game plan? Yes. Was I in the group chat all this whole week? Yeah. Did I have 10 minutes of owner shadowing? Yes.
Did I hire 2 people?
I'm at 1 right now. All right, so I need to hire someone else tomorrow, and I know I'm still on track for my standard. You know, and I keep that in my head, and that's what's pushing me more than, oh, I got 1 phone. Well, if you got 1 phone, then sorry, but like, oh, I got 4 phones out there. Okay, well, look, let's try and figure out something else that's positive. Last one. Did you either practice the systems or did you run a workshop? If you know you're struggling, even if you're a level 2 or you're up there, there's no shame in the game of going up on these walls and writing down the systems and you getting better. And you're having someone better like Brandon who's killing it, and hey, teach me back all the systems so I know how you're doing it so I can really get exactly what you're saying. Teach me Fuji. Because he's going to say a word that he uses in the field with Fuji for greed or something that takes your pitch to another level.
Yeah.
And if you want to grow others where there's new entry levels in here and you want to get them acquainted to our company, you go and grab a workshop. You're like, hey, let me go and explain to you the three ways of how to build a culture here or anything else over there, how to drive sales, what it is to be a leader. There's like 60 papers over there and then some more on that side. You know, to where you're running workshops. You guys neglect this one over here. That's for level ones and level twos. It talks about retraining, how to run a car ride, all different types of stuff that'll help you. Run those workshops and ask yourself, did I do that? Okay, last one, home. We will strive to hit all our goals relating towards the 8 core steps at home. All right, we all know the 8 core steps, association, networking, personal sales, all that type of stuff, but home. 10 to 25 minutes of reading. Why is reading important? But it's not you investing it for yourself, you're investing it in for someone else. Because you're gonna run out of knowledge in the books you read that I have you guys reading. Speaking of that, you bring my book back? All right. But either way, you're gonna add value. You still got my book? Which book do you have? What page are you on? I'm gonna whoop, yo. Whoop.
I'm on chapter 6.
Oh my god, there's like 20 of them.
I know, Chase. There's too much
going on. A dumb. Alright, but either way, educational reading is very important. I can tell when people talk to me that they're not reading. I can tell by actions that they do, they're not reading. I can tell when they're running an interview, they're not reading. Guys, when you're running, when you're doing interviews, you can ask any guy who's been in, I give them analogies, the taco truck stuff, all this different type of things because I read so much. That's how I speak. Like, I know when I'm here and I'm cussing you guys out and I'm acting like a comedian, but when I'm sitting down in an environment where I really need to show my intelligence, I do that because I read so much. I'm already on, it's 11, thank you. She's really trying to go. All right, 10 to 25 minutes of reading. One podcast a day. Keeps failure away. One podcast keeps failure out. How are you listening to stuff? Are you listening to TED Talks? Are you trying to invest in from other people's time? No, not only just reading books, but are you listening to information all the time? It's okay to listen to Bad Bunny, Kevin Gates, or Tory Lanez, or freaking Gucci Mane, but sometimes you gotta take 15 to 20 minutes a day if you're showering, if you're getting dressed, if you're driving over here, anything like that. If you live longer than 30 minutes, like, you should pop in a podcast that's gonna add value, especially the ones we have for Larissa, from Larissa, which gives you guys so much insight on doing breakdowns, on being a leader, on the mindset, the confidence that it takes to get into a management position. And if you don't have that, please reach out to me. But then the last one for home, do you have 2 to 5 one-on-one set for the week? And that's very important because that's going to set it up to where you're networking out with people. No, but at the end of the day, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So we have 12 things that it is to win today. So let's say we look at your LOA. You got 110 doors. So that's a no-no, but you did talk to 85 people. You are around this average. Let's say you're not, okay? Let's say you greeted everybody, you're in a group chat, you owner shadowed, you're already at one person and it's Tuesday, so you got time for one more, so you're winning in that. And you did a workshop to where you added value to someone else, but you haven't read, you haven't done a podcast, but you have this. So you actually have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 out of 12. What's 7 out of 12 percentage wise? That's why everybody has urgency and grab their phone and do it. Oh my God, 58%. So apparently you didn't win the day. Yes, you had a crappy ass day because you didn't do anything correctly. But let's say out of the sales, you suck, all right? You're not having a good time. But you did greet people, you did do the group chat, did all that, you read, podcast, all that, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. What's 8 out of 12?
That's
66%. All right, so you still didn't do good enough. All right, so that example wasn't good. But let's say you're still working hard and you're still talking to people. You're still out there, you're working. You guys all had that where you talk to 80 people and you still can't get no phones or no cells, right? We all been there?
Yeah.
You know, maybe it's something up here, maybe it's enthusiasm. But either way, now you're at 9. Now you're at like Wednesday or Thursday. 75. What's 9 out of 12? 75%.
Damn, that was an ugly thing.
So now you're at 75% to where even though I'm at 3 for the week, let's say for HI or something, I'm still winning the day. I'm still adding value in other aspects of my life, working at that standard that we have for this company, rather than just focusing on, hey, how am I doing in the field? No, how am I doing at home? Well, I am reading every day, I'm listening to a podcast, and I got one-on-one set up to where I can talk to these people for them to get me better. I'm greeting people every day. Oh, we forgot about this one. But I'm game planning, group chat. Oh, so that means it's 10, 10 out of 12, whatsoever. But either way, it's even a higher percentage. But you're doing all the other stuff to where you're not just basing your whole life and your whole day based off of the field. You're looking at a bigger spectrum of like, what is getting me in the management? Is me going out there doing 10 a day going to get me in the management? No. But me out there greeting my people, being in the group chat, engaging with people, game planning with my guys, shadowing what the owner is doing, hiring people on a day-to-day, impacting other people or impacting myself, reading at home, listening to podcasts, and setting up one-on-ones, that's going to get you into management. Now, we all seen top salespeople, they don't last too much. Because that's all they're doing is they're just focusing on the field. But they don't focus on how can I develop myself better? How can I get a better routine in my life at home? How can I focus on building others in the office? You know, if you go in every day and you go to sleep and you notice, hey, here's my check system, how was I? And if you're below anything below 9, then you should fact check yourself and figure out what do I have to do better? You know, but you should never be below 9. Yes, sometimes you miss here, sometimes you miss here. You know, but you should never fall below 9. You should always be at least 75%. That'll tell you that you won the day. You know, and on this paper, I'm gonna print these out. This is for all the leaders with the binders. We're gonna have this on the front end of your folder when we get some more copies. But you're gonna have Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. And it's gonna say, hey, what is, like, you put your percentage and did you win the day or not? To where you know throughout your week, am I progressing well? Am I working towards management? And if I'm not, where do we have to fix it? Is it the field? Is it the office? Or is it at home? Does all that make sense?
Yeah.
But you gotta hold yourself accountable to this. You don't wanna lie to yourself because it doesn't help you. Oh, well, I did listen to like a commercial, so but it was impactful, so I count that. And I did have only one one-on-one, but we did it 5 times. Like, no, don't cheat yourself. Hold yourself to a high standard that you would wanna hold your husband, your wife, your kids, or your next assistant manager for you up to that level. Does that make sense?
Yes!
And if you do that, I promise you, you'll get into management. I promise you, you'll get into leadership. I promise you, you will grow. And that's what I'm looking for. I'm looking for people who are dominating at the home, who are dominating in the field, and who are dominating in the office. You know, and if those people do that on a day-to-day basis, those are the ones that's going to get promoted. Don't you guys agree?
Yes.
You know, and that's the biggest thing we want is who can do that? Who's the one who consistently can go in and out, in and out, in and out, and work their asses off in the field, be the best at home, really fix their habits, but also come in and say, how can I develop people? How can I impact people? Does that make sense?
Yes.
This is why I like to officially promote KP and Missy in leadership. Take his backpack.
Take his
10 backpack.
Take his 10 backpack. Take his cutting board.
Stop.